the mighty Vijayanagara Empire that flourished from 14th century to 17th century has been ruled by four dynasties: Sangama, Saluva, Tulu, and Aravidu. Sometimes, the transition of power from one dynasty to another was a bloodless coup, but on certain occasions, the power struggle within the ruling family was gruesome and blood-curdling. The last emperor from Sangama dynasty, Virupaksha II, was murdered by his own son, who in turn was murdered by his brother Proudharaya. In Saluva lineage, the elder son of Saluva Narasimha, named Timma, was murdered by a rival. Such was the lust and hungry for power brewing within the rank and file of the royal dynasties. These four dynasties were distinct in their military and political decisions, but show a continuous sequence in upholding the royal patronage and generosity. This is the Dharma Vijaya of Vijayanagara Empire.
Shatrunapi kruto dharma palaniya prayatratah. Shatrunapi kruto dharma palaniya prayatratah. शत्रुरेव हि शत्रुश्चाद्धर्मशत्रुर्न कस्यचित्
बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द धार्मिक कंटिन्यूम ऑफ विजयनगरा एम्पायर वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड देयर धार्मिक वाउस. These vows are usually found at the end of their inscriptions. Dana palanayor madhye danat shreyonu palanam danat swargam avapnoti palanad achyutam padam svadatta putrika dhatri pitrudatta sahodari anyadatta cha mata cha dattam bhumim parityajet ekaiva bhagini loke सर्वेषां एव भूभुजां नभोज्य ना करग्राह्य विप्रदत्ता वसुंधरा. बिट्वीन मेकिंग ए डोनेशन एंड प्रोटेक्टिंग ए डोनेशन द लैटर इज हाईली क्रेडिटेबल एज बाय मेकिंग ए डोनेशन वन अचीव्स हेवेंस बट बाय प्रोटेक्शन वन गेन्स साल्वेशन. इफ वन डोनेट्स ए पीस ऑफ लैंड इट इज लाइक डॉटर. And if the donation is made by the father or elders, then it is like sister, and the land donated by others is like a mother. So, do not grab the lands thus donated. For a king, there is only one sister in this whole world, and that is the land donated to Vipras. So, never enjoy or grab the lands thus donated. These verses can be seen in all the Vijayanagara inscriptions. All four dynasties have had these verses inscribed in their grants. Usually, these verses were appended at the end of the inscription. Sometimes, these vows are followed up with a severe curse on the violators. In the entire history of Vijayanagara, not one emperor had undone or revoked the donations and patronage offered by his predecessors. Instead, they have renewed the donations if they have stopped due to change in the power or due to negligence by the local rulers. There are quite a few inscriptions that confirm such care taken by the new emperor to renew the donations made by his predecessors. This excerpt from Epigraphia Karnataka, Volume 1 of Coorg Inscriptions, shows how Harihara, one of the founders of the empire, had renewed a grant issued to a temple centuries before him. A set of inscriptions found in Belur tell us the extent of dharma exhibited by Vijayanagara rulers. An inscription belonging to the period of Narasimha III, father of last Hoysala king Veerabhallala III, records a grant made to Sri Kamalanabha Tirtha, who has been identified as Sri Padmanabha Tirtha, the successor of Sri Madhvacharya. This inscription confirms that a certain grant was made in favor of Kamalanabha Tirtha, alias Padmanabha Tirtha. Another inscription, dated 20th August 1398 AD, talks about the renewal of an old defunct grant issued by Bukkaraya I. It is worthwhile to note that through this inscription, Harihara II had renewed a dysfunctional grant made by his father, Bukkaraya I. The details of Bukka's inscription are not available for now, but it can be assumed that Bukka I might have renewed the grant given to Sri Padmanabha Tirtha during Hoysala Narasimha's reign. Though we do not have the history of Belur Matha established by Sri Padmanabha Tirtha and it is presumed to be lost, yet it is quite heartening to see how the first dynasty of Vijayanagara has renewed a dysfunctional grant that traces back to Hoysala's period. An inscription found in Siti Betta province in Kolar district in Karnataka states that Saluva Narasimha, the establisher of second dynasty, has renewed a grant that was originally issued in 11th century by Rajendra Chola. This grant was issued to Bhairaveshwara temple of Sihatti. This grant of Rajendra Chola was further renewed by Hoysala Veerabhallala. But in the subsequent periods, this grant was violated by some miscreants. Saluva Narasimha restored the order and renewed the grant in favor of the temple. He embellished the grant by constructing a feeding house. From an inscription belonging to the year 1577 AD, we can understand that a particular donation made during Sadashivaraya of Tuluva dynasty's rule was made good by Srirangaraya I of Aravidu dynasty. These are some of the many inscriptions of Vijayanagara rulers that throw light on their virtues as generous donors and benefactors. Their personal feuds or power struggles have never become obstacles to reverse the charity made by their political rivals. Instead, each ruler had made extra provisions for people and the temples. Let us remember and celebrate Dharma Vijaya of Vijayanagara Empire.
Shatrunapi kruto dharma palaniya prayatratah. Shatrunapi kruto dharma पालनीय प्रयत्रतः शत्रुरेव हि शत्रुस्याद् धर्मशत्रुर् न कस्यचित्